Yo guys, today I'm going to show you guys some pro tips on to how to use Mega Knight in Clash Royale guys. So first, we're going to use this Mega Knight deck because this is by far the best Mega Knight deck right now guys. With the buff Lady Miner and also the minions and the goblins which is really strong right now guys. So we're going to play in this Royale tournament right here and let me show you guys some pro tips and tricks with Mega Knight. So first, this is a really high skill deck. So, if you're using this deck, make sure to cycle Wall Breakers. This is by far the best play onto the start of the game. Because this play will literally deal you so much value. It always give you value. Wall Breakers always give your enemy either a neutral elixir trait or a positive elixir trait. Because it is really hard to stop a Wall Breaker completely without getting any damage. And, okay, so his zap is ending up getting some decent damage, but it's totally fine. Let's go minions at the Mega Knight, and that tower should be good to go. Now, the reason that freaking Wall Breakers is actually so good, because due to its elixir cost, it only costs 2 elixir, and it has the potential to deal more than 1000 damage for only 2 elixir, guys. And it is also really hard to stop it. I mean, you can stop it with a lock or barb barrel or zap or snowball, but that is 2 elixir for 2 elixir. So there's not really a really good positive elixir trait for Wall Breakers unless for using skeletons. And because of that, it is really hard to completely stop it for a positive elixir trait. That is why Wall Breakers are so good. For only 2 elixir, you can force out lock, zap, snowball and other stuff which will be really helpful for defense. Now quickly going to go Mega Knight right here for those stinky picks. Boom, Mega Knight absolutely OP guys. Now you want to try to save your Mega Knight and on the early match because you wanna use the Mega Knight as a surprise card. You don't wanna use it if it is not necessary. You want to always use it when the time comes, especially when your enemies stack up a lot of troops, just like what our enemy did right there. That you want to do that so that you can get the maximum value for your Mega Knight as possible. Now I'm going to go miner right here. Boom, at this point we already won the match guys, because look at his king tower. It is good game, there's no way you can defend that. Now quickly going to go Mega Knight, squash the zappies, and let's go Wall Breaker. And that's good game. Miner finish everything off, guys. Now let's quickly to jump to our next match right here, guys. Boom. So, anyways, this deck is really easy. And also, Mega Knight tech skill, because there is actually a really high skill cap for Mega Knight, especially with this deck right here. Because this deck is really hard to use, guys. Now, I said that Wall Breaker is a really good play, but if you split those Wall Breaker, it will be a really better play because your enemy needs to actually stop both of them. Now quickly going to zap the goblins right there so that our daddy miner can go straight to the tower or kill the knight. Okay, kinda decent. Now, okay, that force on the ice spirit. Now quickly going to go miner with minions right here and also some Wall Breaker on the opposite lane. This will deal some decent damage with the minions guys. Just look at the minions guys, it is insane. Look at the damage, it's no joke. Now I suspect he will go a gob barrel, so I'm going to prepare my goblins. Miner right here with the goblins, boom. Now that gob barrel absolutely got destroyed. And also look at that mighty miner completely killing everything. Now going to go a miner right here of my own, so that why not, right? Because why not? Now that knight will get destroyed. Then look at that guys, easy game. Now at this point we already know that he has a lock bait. Now we want to try to not give him rocket value. That's the most important thing. We don't wanna let him having a rocket value. Now quickly going Mega Knight right here. Mega Knight also jump to the gob barrel, absolutely miracle. Now I predict he will go Inferno Tower right here, so I'm going to go minions quickly. Then I'm also going to zap that Inferno because the minions doesn't catch it. Now Mega Knight will jump to the tower. Let's go guys. Now if you face it against an Inferno Tower, you wanna make sure to put your minions on the middle to distract it. That is really important. Now, yep, he will go dead. I will go Daddy Minion quickly. Also activating the bomb to kill everything. That Goblin side here and the Gobs that will kill everything. So I might give him lock value, yes, I know. Now quickly going to go Woolbaker because he just used the lock. That means free damage. Let's go. Boom. Quickly going our Mega Knight right here. He will go all that again. Now I'm going to zap that. Also going to go Goblins with some minions right here. Boom. So he might ending up getting some really decent damage. I'm going to go Miner for this. Also going to go Woolbaker for the Princess. And then yeah guys, boom. Look at those damage, let's go. Look at his King Tower though, you're so dead bro. Okay, now we know that he can rocket everything with for the right tower. Yes, I know he will do that. Now I'm going to quickly go Mega Knight with minions right here because I know he wanna go something. Yep, then I can also go a Miner right here for the right way tower. Then going some Goblins, zap the Goblin gang. And there we go guys, easy dub. Let's go. Minions absolutely destroy that thing. Now let's spam these emotes right here. Ha ha ha. Okay, now against Lockbait, you wanna make sure to not give rocket value. That's the first tip. The second tip is try to use Goblins for the Gob battle instead of the zap, because by using Goblins you can get counter push. The third thing is use your Daddy Miner with a bomb for Goblin Gang, because surprisingly the Daddy Miner's bomb is actually kinda decent for the Goblin Gang. And the fourth thing, use your Miner to snipe away Dark Gob's Princess and Firecracker so that it doesn't stack up and it doesn't ruin your day. And fifth thing, use your minions to distract the Inferno Tower. Okay, now jumping to our next match right here. Split your wall breakers if necessary, because why not? Oh yes, Lava Hound. Okay, this will be a really interesting matchup because this is by far one of the hardest matchup for Mega Knight due to maybe they have like maybe a freaking Inferno Tower or something. Now okay, he went flying machine. In that case, I will quickly do a Mighty Miner bomb. Boom. Then I'm going to zap everything first. Oh, I missed one bat. That will actually be really costly. Now quickly going to go minions. That will kill everything. Then I will go Goblins right here. Also I'm going to go Dark Gob quickly so that it can absolutely shred everything. Look at that guys. You wanna try to cycle to multiple Dark Goblins, because that will be absolutely insane for your defense. Now he will go Lumberjack, but still it gets one hit. Boom. Now let's go Daddy Miner. Daddy Miner absolutely destroyed that push. Now I suspect he will go Skarmy. So yep, there's the Skarmy. Activate bomb. Boom. Okay, that doesn't matter. It still get a few tiny hits. Now in this case, I know that he wanna go Lava Hound, so quickly going to go Miner and Goblins to just pressure him up so that he won't make the full big push. Okay, now this will be really hard to defend though, because we're down 5 elixir and he has a Lava Hound. Now quickly going to go Dark Gob right here to kill the Hound. Or okay, he will go dead. Let's go Daddy Miner first. Then we need to go minions and also zap right here. Boom, to maybe kill that. Okay, now we're on a kind of big problem right here, because he has a baby dragon and also a lot of stuff freaking alive. Now baby dragon needs to be dead or else we're dead. Now quickly going to go Goblins, also Dark Gob right here. Minions right for the flying machine first. Boom. Okay, perfect defense. Now he will go another Dark Gob. Let's go Mega Knight right here. Boom, Mega Knight action. Now he will be go Skarmy for the Dark Gob. Prepare for that. Okay, let's go Daddy Miner for the Lumberjack. Also zap that. Boom, let's go guys. Look at the Dark Gob, absolute MVP. Now quickly going to go Mighty Miner. It will go to the second tower immediately. Let's go. Let's go minions for the flying machine. Boom, perfect defense guys, absolutely easy. Now going to go Miner right here to tank everything. Also going to go Wall Breakers and zap everything right here. Boom. Okay, now quickly going to go Goblins to kite the Lumberjack. Let's go guys, easy defense. everything's easy. Now I'm going to go a surprise Dark Goblin. You don't expect that. Look at that, guys. Because of the surprise Dark Goblin, he lost the match. Now zap that. Oh, 3 HP. Good game. Doesn't matter, guys. So against Lava Hound, you want to cycle to as many Dark Gobs as possible. Save your minions until they do a support card to the Lava Hound. Then use the minions right on top of the support card, so that you can immediately kill the support card. And boom, easy defense. Okay, now you want to also try to pressure your enemy on the other lane with a Miner and Goblins push. You want to go Goblins instead of the Wallbreaker, because even though the Wallbreaker deals so much damage on connection, but for long term, the Goblins actually deal more DPS, because the Wallbreaker dies once it reaches the tower, but the Goblins doesn't. Now going to go Daddy Miner right here for the witch. Oh, he has Keton card. Okay, interesting. Now, maybe I will just split it on the other lane. I don't wanna deal with it. Now let's go this. Let's go the perfect defense. OMG, I'm too good, guys. Now that cannon card will absolutely get destroyed. Okay, let's go. Perfect defense. Okay, not really. Larry might get 2 hits. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Let's go this with. Okay, why do I go minions? That cannon card is dead. I mean, Wo Bowler, same thing. Okay. Now, oh, he has freaking Skeleton King. Okay, this will be a really hard match because he has Skeleton King, cannon card, mine, Wallbreaker. Okay, not Wallbreaker, Bowler. This will be a really hard match, guys, because he has a lot of counters for our push. He has Bowler for Wallbreaker, he has Bowler for OMG. That Skull King absolutely destroy my day. Okay, he has cannon card, he has witch, he has Bowler, he has Skull King, he has a lot of really good stuff. So this will be a really hard match for us. Our Wallbreaker will get destroyed by the Bowler, by the witch, by the cannon card. Like, how on earth we wanna break through? Don't worry, I have a secret tips and tricks. Oh, he has Pekka too. I haven't considered about that. Now we want to try to kill the witch first, because the witch is the main problem right here. Now after that, we can go some goblins. Now Daddy Miner will actually kill the cannon card. Absolutely useful. Let's go. And Daddy Mega Knight will not jump. How disappointing. Wow. Now I'm going to go Wallbreaker right here. Hopefully to bait out a Bowler though. That will be really good. Or a Skeleton King, I guess. Not too bad. Gets one hit. Haha. Now let's go minions. That will kill that. I will go Daddy Mega Knight. Boosh! Oh. No. No, 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 no. Okay, luckily it has activated the ability, which is a miracle for us. Now quickly going to do freaking this. OMG. That Goblin survived. Let's go. Zap that. Boom. OMG, Daddy Miner MVP, guys. Wow. Now let's go Goblins right here. OMG, Dark Goblin, guys. Wow, that tower absolutely got destroyed, guys. So if you see an enemy with a P.E.K.K.A. but they doesn't have Electro Wizard, follow up your push with a freaking Daddy Miner, so that their P.E.K.K.A. can absolutely get destroyed, guys. I mean, where is your brain? Why don't you bring E-Wiz? That's absolutely stupid. But it doesn't matter because you win, haha. Now, against P.E.K.K.A., you want to try to use Daddy Miner for the P.E.K.K.A. if possible, and block the E-Wiz with Goblins, Mega Knight, Minions, especially Minions though. It is really amazing to block the E-Wiz so that your Daddy Miner can absolutely shred the P.E.K.K.A. Okay. Now, jumping to our last match right here, let's see what we face on this match. Okay. Now, let's see what I will do right here. So I won't cycle my Daddy Miner because it's the only tank killer. Mega Knight, absolutely no. 7 elixir. Oh, okay, I will go the Daddy Miner right here. Now maybe he has a Hawk. Oh, Furnace. Okay, maybe he has a Hawk deck or P.E.K.K.A. or Mega Knight. Let's see. Okay, now Dark Gob absolutely shred. Just kidding, he has that. Now I'm going to go Mega Knight right here to tank our Dark Gob. Dark Gob is valuable. Don't kill my Dark Gob, it's bad. OMG, Dark Gob survived. You're so dead, bro. You're so dead. Okay, Dark Gob survived. You're dead. I just want to say that you're dead. Wallbreaker connect. Good game. Now, oh, okay. Maybe actually he's not dead. Now Gobs will actually slay on defense right there. killing the god battle, and miner will get some damage. Let's go. Look at that. 3 hits, 4 hits. Okay, 3 hits. Now, he has giant scale, firecracker, furnace, god battle. I suspect he will have a mirror as well. Not sure though, let's be honest, but I have an instinct and feeling that he has mirror. So in that case, I will go Daddy Miner right here. Yep, he will go Valkyrie. I'm so good. I know he wanna go Valkyrie. That's why I'm going freaking Daddy Miner on the first place. OMG guys, Worldbreaker connected. Now I'm going to zap this, kill the Fire Spirit as the Firecracker. Absolutely value. Now I suspect he will go a Giant Scale on the back. So let's see right here. Where's your Giant Scale? Now I'm going to go this with this quickly, get some cheap damage maybe or what. Oh, smart. He got the giant scale for the gobs. Really smart actually. Because usually, dumb people will just use their giant scale for the miner, and yeah, the gobs will do a lot of damage. Now, freaking that gob will get tons of damage on the lane. Now I'm going to do this. Oh, he has Mega Knight. Oh, I mean Ram Rider, same thing. You're so dead. Never mind, I'm the one that is dead. Oh, freaking Mega Knight jump. Let's go. Now he will have that. Okay, I'm actually kind of screwed right now. I'm on a kind of bad situation because yeah, he will go another furnace and he will. Okay, so if he stack up the firecracker, I can actually lose this match. If I wanna win, I need to kill his firecracker as fast as possible. Now, oh yep, he will go firecracker, I expect that. Let's go miner quickly, boom. Then I can go minions right here. Oh, he has Sparky too, huh? Let's zap that, I didn't want any Sparky action. Let's go, Mega Knight jump, it's good game. Mega Knight already jump, and the Dark Dome actually connect. Let's go, good game, no coming back, easy dub guys. So I guess spawners, you want to try to use miner maybe onto their spawner if possible, but if you see that they're bringing a dark gob or a firecracker, prioritize that first. And if they have like a giant scale or mega knight of their own, use Daddy Miner on that and save your own mega knight for anything else like a battle ramp or a ramp rider or something. So anyways, thanks for watching. Hopefully these pro tips can help you. See ya, bye.